quality education has access to education. In particular, City College of San Francisco, our great champ. I also want to say one other thing, too. We passed Prop A in San Francisco to fund City College. Not to fund bureaucrats, not to fund the decertification process. We put that money in there to take care of City College. That's where we want that money to be used. And then thirdly, we want elected trustees back in place to do the job that they have been doing and to do the job better and to make sure that we are fully covered by the elected will of San Franciscans. So let's go to City College. Let's win in court. Thank you.
Hi everybody, I'm Winsong. I'm a student at City College. Resolvable problems, but was respected
nationally for academic excellence and humane treatment of our highly competent faculty and staff. My fellow trustees and local, I assume until 2012 that the ACCJC was committed to ensuring the instructional quality and physical of the ACCJC has a privatizing agenda and the ACCJC leadership are power trained. At City College and throughout the state. Also, our college is the college of the people. There is nothing to fear from the legitimate accreditation process. To assessing the quality of performance and to provide a path to improvement. Students also evaluate performance, which improves and it affirms democratic principles. Will begin the official
thank you for being here. We have a chance. We need you. begin with, I want to see everybody here tomorrow. No excuses. Please commit yourself. We want to keep City College open. You have to help. I want you here at 7 o'clock. Especially the new teacher. Beautiful, great, thank you. To begin with, unable to communicate because of the teachers at City College. I remember when I came and I couldn't say even hello. I didn't really know what it means, hello. And I felt so happy when I start communicating. I really wanted to cry when I start telling the people what's going on with the teachers in El Salvador. I don't want to tell you my home story. All I want to say is that the teachers at City College prepare me to be here. Prepare me to be who am I now. I am a principal teacher. I was a principal teacher for San Francisco Unified for 20 years. While I was studying English, thanks a billion to the ESL teachers at City College who prepared immigrants for to have a better chance. Thanks to City College who made a strong base for me. Thanks a billion. I don't have enough faith. I don't really have much to say to the teachers at City College. They were great. They encouraged me to continue forward. I moved forward. I went to San Francisco today, got my BA and then my MA. Probably I get my PhD, okay? But anyway, please come tomorrow. And remember, they are not killing us for being here. When I was living in El Salvador, they were pointing guns at us when we were demonstrating, like we are doing here. We are not here. Oh, by the way, I don't really know personally Dennis Herrera, but I'm sending you a billion hugs, a billion thanks, because without you, we weren't here. Thank you, Mr. Herrera. Thank you so much. Anyway, I just want to say thank you to all of us who are here, and thanks to my beautiful union that I love so much. I know that the union is power. Union means power. ACCJC means greed. ACCJC means incarceration. ACCJC means corporation, privatization. We have to stop now. Thank you.
Thank you.
Privatization. Yeah. Next, it's my pleasure to introduce a student organizer with Mecha at City College, Lalo Gonzalez.
Yeah. All right, everyone, who's exhausted?
Woo.
All right, exactly. For the last 2 years, who would have thought that we'd be out here right now? Remember what people were saying 2 years ago?
Yeah.
That it was a conspiracy theory that no way this could be happening, and look at it now. We were able to actually get a lawsuit going. Yeah. Give ourselves a round of applause for that. This lawsuit represents a lot to us, but it also represents how much our organizing efforts have actually paid off. We have been organizing for doing so many countless hours into actually mobilizing these people. How many people have actually been working on flyers, countless conversations with students, faculty, protests, rallies, thousands of individuals participating in our mobilization efforts, and they've been paying off.
Yes.
And now we have this lawsuit, which is one giant step forward in our actual movement. But we have to know that after this lawsuit is not over. We have to continue mobilizing. We have to continue fighting against all of the cuts. We have to continue fighting against the payment policy. We have to continue fighting the Obama's relatives actually gone from this campus.
Yeah.
We have to keep on fighting Bob Agrella. Had to leave City College. We cannot just simply go home after the trial. We have to continue mobilizing. So, I would like to invite you all to the next general meeting. It's very important. The next general meeting for CCSF is occurring on Michigan campus, room 108 at 5:30 p.m. It's extremely important that we show up and continue mobilizing.
November 5th.
Oh, November 5th, I'm sorry, November 5th. That's one detail I missed. November 5th, Mission Campus, room 108, 5:30 p.m. We have to continue mobilizing, we have to continue fighting for our education. It's a united front with students, faculty, SDS, recognize you. All of the people must come together next make sure that Bob Latrell is ousted. Make sure we have our Board of Trustees back with all the decision-making power so we can actually make an influence on our college. So please, come out November 5th. Very important. Thank you all for coming out. This is great. I know it's extremely early. I'm exhausted a bit. I came at 1:30 in the morning to Bob, and I'm a bit jet lagged. But we must continue fighting. My pleasure to invite another great organizer, student trustee, Chanel Williams. Give it up for Chanel.
Thank you, Lalo. Brothers and sisters, the time has come for justice.
Yes.
Yeah. Today, it is not City College of San Francisco that's on trial. Today, we will have our justice heard and see the ACCJC answer to the people of California.
Yes.
For the wrong they have committed to City College of San Francisco. We want justice for the 90,000 students that came to CCSF to pursue their educational goal and the 15,000 students that have been pushed out of our college since 2012. Over the remainder of our students live in fear. We want justice for the teachers, the staff, and even the administrators that have had to endure hostile work conditions causing burnout and early retirement. That's right. We want justice for the San Francisco voters that approved Proposition A and democratically elected our Board of Trustees to see their funds misspent and to see our Board of Trustees shut down.
Yeah.
Woo! We want justice for the entire community of San Francisco, the 1 in 3 San Franciscans, and all the Bay Area residents that depend on this resource. That depend on this resource. The resource to educate from home. The single mother, the immigrant, who wants to learn English, the veteran, the homeless, the high school dropout, the individual getting out of jail. Everyone who can benefit from the education that CCSF provides. I believe that we are not asking for enough. ACCJC has wronged and damaged one of the best community colleges in the country. And they will be held accountable. In what world do we live in where a body that is funded by the people and put in place to serve our students take away our opportunity for education? This isn't right and this will not stand. And it's now my pleasure to introduce someone who I know we can trust in the state assembly that will fight for us and that will continue fighting for our city college to remain open and accredited. None other than David Coco.
Incredible. But listen, we have not just a trial about City College, we have a trial about what direction the city is going in. We have a trial that will be taking place on November 4th because we are 8 days away from, I think, the most important election that we have seen in a generation. We are here today because what's happening with City College is symbolic of what's going on with the rest of San Francisco. There are some people who have put up a big for sale sign in the city and county of San Francisco. And they're trying to do that here with City College. This is about people trying to privatize public education. That is what's behind this. I see some of the trustees, Anita Greer, Dr. Greer, I see Raphael Mandelman, I see the students. And I want you to know that we know that the law and the facts in this case are on our side. I want to thank City Attorney Dennis Herrera, but I want you to know that regardless of what happens in this court, we have a larger fight. We have a larger fight for the future of San Francisco. As City College goes, so does San Francisco. And we are not going to let this institution go out of business. And not only are we going to protect it, but we need to make sure that it's a robust institution that serves every member of our community. No to privatization. No to money interest. Yes to the people. Yes to the people. Yes to City College. Thank you so
much.
Yay! Yay! Thank you, Mr. Dana, one more time.
Yay! All right, next, our next speaker is Josh Pexel. He's part of CFC, the
President.
Thank you, Lalo. It's great to be here, and it's great to see such a enthusiastic turnout. I want to commend all of you. You've really been the heart and soul of keeping this fight going, and I think we're going to see some results this week. You know, the fight around the ACCJC and City College of San Francisco can be quite complicated, and frankly, for most folks, it's a little bit confusing, right? It's kind of like the inside baseball of the community college world. But for me, this is about the heart and soul of community colleges. And what makes this fight so important is that all of you in City College of San Francisco, the entire education community, have been willing to stand up and say, our community college has to be a broad vision of community college. It's got to be a community college that not only educates high school seniors wanting to get a four-year degree, but it's got to be a place where veterans can come back and get the skills they need to be to get back into civilian life. It's got to be a place where folks who want to acquire English as a second language can come back, where workers can get additional skills, and where our seniors can come back and take classes to maintain a rich and fulfilling life. And that's why ACCJC is picking on City College, because all of you have stood up and said, we are not going to go for this narrow vision of community colleges that they are imposing on other colleges around the state. This is about the heart and soul of what our higher ed should look like, and it is part of the vision for the California Master Plan laid out 50 years ago. You're fighting for that vision. I commend you, and let's bring you home to victory this week. Thank you very much.
Marshall Powers is an awesome stand for City College with Dennis Herrera. So we owe him a great gratitude. I said we're going to win, and I really, really hope to win this week. But I will tell you that win or lose, we are going to keep fighting, and we are going to reform accreditation in California. Because what is happening to San Francisco is not happening to San Francisco alone. It's happening to community colleges throughout the state. It's too earlier, 5, 10 years ago, when they shut down colleges, people didn't stand up like this. But if we don't stand up and we don't fight, this will continue happening to community colleges around the state. So we are going to win. We are going to keep fighting until we have won. And I'm so glad to have all of you, to be with all of you in this fight. And thank you, CFC, and thank you, Josh Pestroff, for all that you have done to fight for San Francisco and all community colleges.